That was the overture to the Polish Partita, originally written for two lutes by George Telemann. I'd like to welcome you all to the chapel here at Warder, in the heart of the Wiltshire countryside, to hear this programme of music of two guitars with my colleague John Williams. The church, or should I say the chapel itself, is very unusual and I think most beautiful. It is very elaborately decorated, but in a very restrained Baroque, or perhaps I should say Palladio style. And all this ornamentation gives a great deal to the characteristic of the acoustic, which makes our instruments here this evening sound so beautiful and resonant. I think in the 18th century, what the eye saw to be beautiful, particularly in interior design and proportion, you can be sure that the ear was also equally well served. And this chapel certainly proves that to be indeed correct. I myself have given a number of recitals here, sometimes broadcast or televised, and I've made many records with great pleasure, in as much as one can get any pleasure making gramophone records. But it is wonderful to be able to use this wonderful acoustic. And of course, John here is no stranger to the chapel at Warder, because it was here that we made our first two LP records. Well, now, this Partita Polonoise, which you heard at the beginning, in fact, you heard only the first overture, we're now proposing to play the complete suite, not counting the overture, of course. And the next piece will be Harlequinade, and then a very unusual and amusing piece called Le Rire, which I suppose translated means a laugh. And then comes an old French dance called a rigodon. And then another amusing piece called Combattant, which is, as the name suggests, a sort of friendly combat between John Williams and myself. And we hope we both win equally. And then finally, the whole suite comes to an end with a jig. So here we will give you the remainder of the Polish Partita by Telemann. Thank you.
We're going to continue with a duet for two guitars by the Spanish composer Fernando Soro. This is Opus 54, a fantasy. It has two movements. Although it begins with a slow andante, this first movement leads into a theme and variations, and these are followed by a movement called Pas d'Espagnol, literally the Spanish step. It's a sort of a Spanish dance type piece. Thank you.
Thank you.
undoubtedly the two most famous Spanish composers of the 19th century, or the latter part of the 19th century, was Granados and Albéniz. They were almost contemporary, and both composers were very much influenced by the resurgence of interest in folklorical music and dancing. And now these next two pieces, one by Granados and the other by Albéniz, reflect this great interest in the Spanish dance. The first comes from a collection of 12 Spanish dances by Granados, and we will play number 11. The second is a curious but very well-known piece because it reflects the atmosphere of a certain part of Spain, Castilla, and yet the musical material itself is couched in the form of a Spanish dance known as a sigadillas. Thank you.
Well, it's often said that the best, most effective Spanish music was not written by Spaniards, but by Belgians, Russians, and Frenchmen, in particular, Frenchmen. And in very particular, Debussy. And we're going to play now three pieces by Debussy, arranged for two guitars. Although With that introduction, it seems strange that we're going to play three particularly French-type pieces. But we feel that Debussy's impressionistic and highly colorful, and in these cases, delicate textures are very suitable to the guitar. And the titles of them, these three pieces, first of all, Rêverie, secondly, Golliwog's Cakewalk, and last, Clair de Lune.
Thank you. Thank you.